If you're the Hurricanes, you had a tough road trip with Minnesota, Winnipeg, and Tampa Bay. You found a way to get 2 points in Minnesota, but you got to feel you left some things on the table. So if you're this team right now, where are you after that road trip where you're thinking you could have come away with more than just two?
Yeah, I think you remain confident and you stay positive in that locker room. The two losses came from minor mistakes that are easily fixed, Mike. It's not a big X's and O's thing.
Mikko Rantanen. He'll draw it away from Jordan Staal. At the point, Tyson Barry. Turning stick of Rantanen diagonally across. MacKinnon, his shot blocked. It skitters in on McElhinney. He's barreled into. The puck goes in. No goal here.
Let's watch Bork in front of the net. Does he get pushed? Good rebound control. That's something I watch. It's Jost, and he gets pushed in. So that's the right non-call. The push comes from Calvin DeHaan to begin the season. There he makes a heck of a play in front of his own net.
The Canes reset. Calvin DeHaan fans on his first pass opportunity. Now he springs Svechnikov for a shot stopped by Philip Grubauer.
Svechnikov, so many players would have shot from the severe angle, but he was on the backhand and had the composure to hold on with his strength, get to the middle of the ice for a grade A chance, and Grubauer, his best stop of this young hockey game.
As we go far to near point with it, Slavin up top, it's Ferland blocked again, this time by Kamenev. And now Slavin down the boards. Walks in the Colorado zone in front. Grubauer said no on Teuvo Teravainen.
Boy, Slavin and Hamilton's chemistry is growing by the day in the game. And they were part of being able to keep the puck in the Colorado zone, bring fresh troops on the ice. And Slavin makes a heck of a play, drawing two Colorado players.
Little dump and chase, Grubauer out to play it. Far point, fed along that time by Brett Pesce. Far corner for Warren Fogle. Bit of a cycle here for the Hurricanes. Jordan Staal, double teamed at back of the goal in front. Williams on the doorstep denied. Fogle was taken down, and the Canes will get a power play. It's Van Riemsdyk with McElhinney on the bench. Six skaters out. Van Riemsdyk out of the corner. Centered in front, doorstep banging attempt that time by Fogle is denied by Philip Grubauer. And it comes out to center ice. Nathan MacKinnon. We'll send it back for Landeskog, who scores! Gabriel Landeskog continues his scoring ways.
As I continue to talk about, when they're not out against Slavin and Hamilton, here they're against the two righties, Pesce and Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk cannot come over and seal, and Curtis McElhinney would like to have that on the short side.
And he is big at 6'4", 215. Now Justin Falk will take it back through center ice. He'll hinge along. Goes by Ian Cole. Cole in back of Grubauer reverses to Martinook in front. Just between the wickets of Lucas Wallmark.
Martinook, that centering attempt just hit Soderberg.
Carolina reorganizing as it pinballs back in the Kane zone. Teravainen, stretch pass again. Breakaway. Michael Ferland's in. Shut down by Grubauer. That time it worked. Michael Ferland, who has goals in back-to-back games.
Heck of a pass from Teuvo Teravainen. On sides, goes to the backhand and elevates the puck. And Philip Grubauer creates layers and catches it with the arm. Textbook on top of that pad. What a stop from Grubauer.
Trust me, through center. Moving up now, Nathan MacKinnon for Gabriel Landeskog. Landeskog, seam pass, he got it back and he scores! Fortunate bounce for Gabriel Landeskog, who tried to be unselfish, then had to be selfish.
This pass to the middle is going to go off the skate, I believe, of Jordan Martinook. However, the board battle is one to even create the bounce from MacKinnon. Martinook is just doing his job, preventing the seam pass. It goes off his skate, right onto the tape of Landeskog. No chance for McElhinney. He's trying to get the push to go across.
8:40 left, second period play, 2-0 Colorado, and 69 seconds left on the power play. Rantanen, far point, Tyson Barry. Near side, it's MacKinnon. Nathan MacKinnon with a shot blocked by Brett Pesce.
Big block from Pesce. The Hurricanes penalty killers have had trouble creating 200-foot pressure. Maybe this is the start of something.
3:19 left in the period. Hamilton holding on to it along the boards. Justin Williams, one more time, a pass detected by Bork. It's loose. Williams up top, Slavin. His shot stopped by Grubauer. Rebound loose. And the Avalanche is. Gabriel Bork got to it.
You can feel the nerves on the Hurricanes power play up here. I do think that Dougie Hamilton, the decisions he makes at the offensive blue line, gives Carolina the best chance of getting out of the rut.
And Colorado will survive that and get it out. A 1:47 left, second period play. Avalanche lead it 2-0. This is Landeskog in front. McElhaney said no. McKinnon's second chance. Curtis McElhaney got that one too.
Creates time and space. You can just see the seamless chemistry they have in McElhaney with a super stop, moving from right to left to keep this a two-goal game.
You were the stand-in yesterday?
What?
Not in that
she's
sense,
she's not here.
Course.
She's still. She's in Finland, and we were having a coffee, and he said, I proposed to her.
Look out. Colin Wilson, a steal denied by Curtis McElhaney and Sebastian Aho.
Carolina can put together a push and come back. Remember these saves. The one I mentioned late in the second. Van Riemsdyk cannot handle the pressure.
Just over 5 minutes gone in this third period. Hurricanes trail it 2-0. Pulling up Michael Ferlin, defended by Zadorov. Brought in by Teravainen. He'll shift right out in front. Ferlin's there. Grubauer shut it down. And he locates the puck.
If he needs to wait for help to arrive, that's what he does. And that's what he does here. And then Teravainen, no fear, making the move on Kerfoot to the middle of the ice. And Ferlin follows up what he started.
Okay, good news. Good pickup out to center. Jordan Staal over the line in the zone for Hamilton on a drop pass. It deflects wide. Out of the corner. Andre Svechnikov in tight. Bogle shut down. Paddle down for Grubauer. They get after it again. Svechnikov.
Go to the net. Good things are going to happen. You're going to score. You're going to create buzz with the crowd. Hurricanes are going to go back to the power play.
Getting to it is Justin Falk. A reset. Slavin out of the reach of Warren Fogle. All the way back in the Avalanche zone. Staal gets to it out in front. Cleaned up. Defended by Nemeth. Williams on a turnover. Picked off. Philip Grubauer. Continues his wizardry and goal. The last chance, Justin Williams on a fortuitous bounce.
Off of that redirection.
Backhand in tight, Teravainen, and Grubauer was ready for that one.
50-50 puck and a heck of a job from Ferlin getting it to the front of the net to give Teravainen and company a chance.
Nathan McKinnon, Slavin, knocks down Rantanen. McKinnon's away, 2-on-1. He'll delay, he'll score! What a bullet! Short side, Nathan McKinnon. 3:09 left in regulation time. 3-0 Colorado.
My gosh, what a shot. Lower portion of the screen is Nathan McKinnon. Straight out 2-on-1. McElhaney's got the shot. Hamilton, his job is to deny the pass, then try to seal the shot. Impossible to do that.
Their record is 0-5-2 now. Sebastian Aho moving up on Samuel Girard, who gives him a rough ride. 2:37 on the clock. Aho's streak on the line. They score! Sebastian Aho digs it out. Michael Ferlin cashes in. It's a lifeline for Carolina.
Well, Aho's streak continues, and Ferlin has been Carolina's most dangerous player. And it's all about the quick release. What a job to be able to turn, find that seam between the two defensemen, Johnson and Girard, and Ferlin wastes no time. Grubauer's been great. Colorado's won in special teams.
That'll do it. The Hurricanes have dropped 3 in a row. Jared Bednar and the Colorado Avalanche come to town, and they get it done. They continue a very impressive road trip, and the success for Philip Grubauer in this building. He's 5-2 lifetime here now as he and his teammates defeat the Carolina Hurricanes 3-1.